What's up, guys? I'm Jay.
And I'm Adam.
And we are Encounter Wargaming. And this is our third video in our Introduction to Infinity series. I hope you guys have enjoyed the first two. And if you want to go back to the beginning of the playlist, just click right there. And it'll lead you right back to the beginning. So you can watch us from the start. So my Haqqislam are 0-2 at this point, and we're going back against the Jing. So what's the scenario today, Adam?
That's right. We found ourselves in the food court. So wide open. There's apparently some catapult in the atmospheric dome that's holding this place together. That is launching a tiger soldier into the back lines. They're trying to cover the retreat of the Haqqislam throughout the space station. So that's going to be new and fun. But for the most part, the rest of the forces are sweeping through the food court, trying to clear them out. So let's look at the forces and see the table and get to it.
Sweet.
So the forces have expanded a little bit. I have my 3 Zanshi, my 1 Terracotta soldier, also called a Zuyong, and then my Tiger soldier. So I got 5 orders and my lieutenant order.
And I, again, have the Gulam infantry that we've been using so far, my red turban with the unpronounceable name, and Tuareg sniper.
Awesome.
So same thing, I'm getting a camel marker on this one because she's going to be camouflaged to start and giving me, of course, the 5 orders and the extra lieutenant order to use every turn.
And let's be clear on this too. So this mission actually assigns our lieutenant for us. So for me, it's my Zuyong, Terracotta soldier, and for Jason, it's the red turban. So this is our food court. We just have various food shops lined up here with other little noodle shops spread out. So pretty open, nice big open lanes of firing.
Which might lead to a quick game.
That's right. So let's do our roll for on our willpower,
right,
to see who deploys and goes first. So we both pass.
But yours is bigger than mine, so you win.
Higher. That's correct.
All right.
And I think I will choose to deploy first again.
Okay.
You can go first.
Cool.
So here's our deployment. I have 1 Zanshi standing in the corner of the building here. Another Zanshi and my Terracotta soldier. And my last Zanshi down on the floor next to that cargo box. And here we go. Here's Jason's forces. What do you got?
I got all my Gulam hiding behind that little crate there. Hoping to wrap around and get some flank action going on. And then I got my red turban over here hiding back here. And my camo marker right here, which normally you wouldn't be able to tell what it is, but clearly in this mission it's the cypher.
Awesome. And I've got my tiger soldier waiting to air deploy later.
Good.
So Jason has the initiative. Let's see what happens.
Start by... visibility here. I'm going to use my first order to activate this Gulam. Let's see if we'll go 4 that way. And then I guess another 4 won't get me up top, but it'll get me right to the ladder. I'm going to use my second order to move this guy with him. 2. Still don't think you can see me, which is excellent, so it's going to be a 4 there. My third order, I'm just going to keep my Gulam together. It's just, how visible am I? I think I'm safe if I go here. Can you see me?
Nope.
Perfect. She's going to move another 4 up here. Keeping my guys together. Now, my lieutenant is going to be interesting. In order to move out, he theoretically has 2 orders that I can do. So maybe I'll use the first order to actually get him and hide here. Yeah, there's no way you could have. If you couldn't see him to start, there's no way you could have seen him here. Can you see him from there?
No.
Yeah, I don't think so. Okay. And he's going to use the second order to get up on the building, which you might be able to see him now.
Yes, but that's your second short skill, so I can't declare arrows.
No, that's my first short skill in my second order.
Ooh, fancy. So you did your lieutenant order.
Yes,
great.
I did your lieutenant order.
Then I will definitely declare some arrows. I am going to BS attack with all three of these guys on Earth.
Okay. Long range.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want my second one to be a move, so you're just going to be shooting at me, I guess.
Sounds good.
Right? I wanted to get him up there and move it across. So.
Got it. So combi rifle is, we'll just check the modifiers on it, but it's 16, is plus 3, so it's definitely not in the 16, for any of them, but they're all combi rifles, and so after the 16 is...
Negative 3, up to 32 inches, so the whole table's 32, so you're...
Okay, so it'll be at the negative 3, So let's do him first. He's got a BS of 13.
Okay.
Minus 3 brings it down to 10. So we'll do his shot. That's a 9. I believe that hits.
Well, I guess so.
Yeah.
But your damage is 13?
Yes, it is 13.
From here, I gotta have armor. I gotta have cover, right? Oh, yeah, I can see.
It's true line of sight, but... I have to be in base contact.
It's base contact.
That's so silly. Okay, so I'm just adding 1. So I need a 13.
Oh, didn't get it.
That's a 13. So it goes through?
It does go through.
That just means he's dead. Yeah. Just like that. Wow. There's a lot of silliness in this game. Okay, so for my final order, it's just going to be a move with the camo.
Okay.
Putting her there.
So I'll... declare a discover.
Okay.
From all three of these guys.
Okay. That has ranges, modifiers, and stuff too, right?
Yeah. So this one's new for us for this mission.
Zero. So 8 to 32 is 0.
Okay.
So you should be good.
And what is it,
range?
Willpower?
I mean, you're at 20. Discover has to be in a line of fire. Appropriate mod to its willpower attribute.
Okay, so for my Terracotta Soldier, he gets a 4, which is easily under, and discovers.
Okay.
And surprise! We didn't know who that was. Sniper gets revealed.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so keep going.
That's my turn.
Okay. So you just moved her the one time, first short skill. I declare discover, and then what do you do?
Right, well, I actually moved her twice. I should have declared one to there. You discovered her there, and then I guess I can...
Oh, okay, then my second one is moving.
My second one was a move. What I did is I moved the counter twice, and then you did your... Which is the wrong order to do things.
Right, so she gets discovered there, and then she moves up to the wall.
And then, yeah, I was moving her this way to the wall. That's where I had it. Yeah.
Cool. All right, so for my turn, let's do...
So you can drop that guy in at any point?
Yeah, I guess so. Declare an order. Yeah, I don't think it said any particular turn to do
it. It just takes a full order to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Sounds good.
So, I will actually... I'm going to try and drop right here. Fully on the table. And so what we do is we place that marker. So it has to be... can't touch any terrain or anything. And then I get to put him anywhere inside of it. So I'll put him... I guess it's a her. Right there, base contact with that.
Yeah, it's got boobs.
and now I have to pass a... What was it? Physique? There, you know what?
So you have a good chance.
I think I'm actually... I'm going to try something different.
Yeah.
I'm going to go up there.
Yeah, it said as long as it was an open area.
Yeah, place it right there.
Doesn't matter that it's terrain.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, so 12.
There you go.
There it is. Cool, so she stays there. Would you mind removing that template? Thank you, sir. do arrows happen on that?
Sorry?
Because I wonder if arrows happen on that.
Yeah, now it would.
Because
before you were over there, so I wouldn't have gotten it.
So it does count as a short skill that's like arrow-worthy.
It says I can declare arrows.
Against it? Okay.
Once a combat jump is resolved, the reactive player may declare their arrows.
Okay.
So right now, this guy here, I think, can see her, because his 180 would be this way.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, the sniper.
Yeah.
Right?
So let's try it.
This guy... Don't know if there's a line there. Yeah, maybe.
Cool.
Think I can?
Yeah.
Okay. So I got two rifles and one sniper rifle. Correct?
Cool. Yeah.
Okay. But it's an ARO, so I only get one die.
And the sniper's inside of eight. I don't know if that matters.
Yeah, it'll be negative three.
Cool. So which one are we doing first?
I guess we'll do the sniper first, since it's so negative.
So add on a total of negative nine. So negative three for being inside of eight, negative three for cover, negative three for mimetism.
Mimetism. Okay.
Sneaky, sneaky.
So that's almost impossible then.
Yeah, what's your BS?
I've got a BS of 11.
Ooh.
So I have to roll a two.
Okay, two or less.
One! It's a three!
It's a three.
Wow!
Alright.
Okay, that's tough, man. That's
so
tough.
This guy here?
Yeah. So, a second ago I was just trying to learn the rifle again. We don't have these memorized quite yet. The rifle / shotgun.
So if it's the rifle, it's plus three if it's outside of eight.
Yes, that's correct.
So you do that.
Yeah, so they're both going to fire the rifle.
Okay.
So the closest one?
Yep.
So
it'll be minus six now.
Right, because there's no range modifier, just the cover and the mimetism.
Yeah.
So I need a five or less.
Okay.
That's a one.
You got a one.
All right,
oh,
armor
no.
roll.
Great. Could you tell me what my armor is on this guy?
Two.
So two plus three for the cover, and your damage is 13. So I have a total of plus five, and
two.
I need to get over 13.
Nine.
Oh, that's a 12.
Yep, that's not enough.
So I don't get through.
Does you only have one wound?
Maybe.
Yep.
One wound?
Next. Ugh,
dead.
Wow, things die so easily in this game.
All right, so that's the end of that.
Okay.
Let's go on to... Jason loves it. He loves it and hates it. Let's do some of these.
So easy.
So, I'm... let's start here. I'm going to declare a move as my first one of zero. So you can declare any arrows. Probably your sniper.
Yeah. I don't think the guy on the ground here could probably, no. Because if you couldn't see me, I can't see you.
Right.
But, are you trying to move to the ground?
Nope, I'm just moving zero and then I'm gonna shoot you.
Oh, just to get it out of the way.
Yeah.
I see. Okay. Alright, so the sniper's gonna have to take a shot.
Alright.
I think you're more than 16 at this point. I would hope so. 16 there.
Yep.
Perfect. That gives me plus three. And I just get one shot, right?
Yep. And I got three for my combo rifle. Oh, I got an awful roll.
I got one. So.
Because. So let me
that gives me a four, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, no. So your BS is plus three. And you just have to get under your BS.
Oh, right. So still
a
one. Okay.
Yeah. Mine is. You actually have TO camo, right? Alright, so we've just looked through. And so you always have TO camo, which means it's always minus six. So it's going to be minus 9 because it also is cover. And I got a 7. And I needed 13 minus 9. I need a 4 or less. And Jay, you got a 1. So that's one hit against me.
Oh, because your 7 fails. Because
I failed.
Yeah, I just assumed your 7 would cancel me.
Yep.
So you got an armor roll.
I have an armor of 3. Plus 3 for the cover. And what's the damage on a sniper rifle?
Damage is 15.
15.
Woo! What it says.
So 6 plus this.
Yeah, your guy hasn't.
I got a 14, so I got 19. So I do pass my armor, which is sweet.
Okay.
I can move over to this dude here, who is actually, we discovered, he could have seen that dude who ran up over there. So I'm just going to declare a move of 0 and shoot ya.
Okay. Shoot that guy there.
So yeah, you can declare an arrow after I do my move.
My arrow is going to be shoot you back.
Yep. Let's do it.
Okay. Face to face.
Yep.
Now, is there modifiers at this range? I'll measure.
You're using the combi rifle, I'm using the rifle.
Yep, so just check my 16.
Yep, 16 is negative 3 for both of us.
I'm actually outside of 16.
Okay, so it's negative 3 to both of us.
Mm-hmm. I have cover.
So I'm getting negative 6?
Yes. So your BS then is 5?
Oh no, he's wide open.
So yeah, my BS goes down to 5, so I fail.
Mine's 8, so I got 2 successes.
Okay, so I got 2 armor rolls?
2 armor rolls.
And you straight armor?
Armor is 1 plus, and you gotta be a 13.
And he's dead twice over.
Yeah. So what I actually should have done is shot him first, so that he didn't kill my tiger soldier.
She killed the tiger soldier.
Didn't she? No, she missed and he killed.
Oh. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. So next I'm going to declare a move of 0, and you can declare an arrow.
For her?
Yeah.
She's going to shoot you back, because that sniper rifle is awesome.
Yeah. Cool. And then I'm going to shoot you with my combi rifle. Yep. I'm going to be minus 9. You're minus 6 for that, plus cover. And you'll just be minus 3, plus 3.
Correct.
Yeah.
Cool. So I'm just straight roll.
Yeah, yes. And I'm going for 2s. 1s and 2s.
You're going for 1s and 2s. Holy crap.
I guess it's 1.
Okay.
I do not do it.
I fail too.
All right.
Cool. Nothing happens.
All right. And next, I'm actually going to declare another order, because I don't have to move all of them. I might as well just keep using this guy to shoot you, because he's tougher.
It's true. You can use anybody you want.
Yeah. So let's just do my fourth order on this guy.
Okay.
Actually, let me make sure I did all my orders right. He's 1, 2, 3, 4. So this would be 5. This is my 5th order. Yeah, let's do it. So him shooting the sniper. Same stats. He's 13 minus 9, so I need... What do I need? 13 minus 9 is 4 is less. So I fail on all
3. So I'm 11 plus 3?
Plus 3 and minus 3 for the cover.
Okay, so it's just straight 11, so that's a critical.
Oh no! So I don't get an armor and I fail all 3.
Wait, you might be able to cancel? No?
Nope.
Okay.
Yeah, because I failed all 3 of mine.
So he's got 2 wounds, right?
Yeah. So take a wound on him.
Yeah.
And I'll use my lieutenant order on... I kept the same girl as my lieutenant.
Nope. So your lieutenant is this guy. You
oh, yeah, I have to. Yeah, that's right. So him. So I'll just do it one more time.
Okay.
Shooting you. I did get a 2.
And so did I.
Which for me is a crit.
For you is a critical.
Yeah.
Wow.
Because I need 2.
Oh, because you were negative. Yeah, okay. Because normally they would cancel each other out.
Yeah.
Right? But so, critical can't be canceled.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
And so I got to do an armor roll on her.
Which you don't get on crits.
Oh, man. Because she's just dead? Wow.
Yeah. Bam. Killed that sniper. But took a wound for it. And that's all my orders.
Okay.
So we'll pause this and get ready for turn number 2.
That was a rough turn. So now that my lieutenant's dead, I've got these irregular orders, which means that I can't just load one guy up. I gotta use one at a time on each guy. So, I spend this irregular order and move her 4 up to here, hugging the wall. And hopefully,
mm-hmm.
I can get a line of sight
yep.
on her. Or is that a guy? That's Jim.
Cool.
So, you get to declare your ARO.
Yeah, I'm gonna BS ARO.
Okay.
So
I'm gonna fire 3 shots at you.
Okay, you got a rifle. I got a combi rifle.
I got a rifle. I'm pretty sure at this range I should be good. It's more than 8, right? 8 is the magic number?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're just straight.
Right. So we're both. Yeah, because we're both plus 3 for our gun, but
we
minus
both
3
have
cover. Cover.
So we're just straight rolls.
Yep.
We both have 11, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
I fail, mate.
And I succeed with 1.
Okay, so right. I make an armor roll.
Okay.
1 for my armor, 3 for the cover, so a plus 4, and I need to get a 13.
And 13, yep.
And I get it with 20.
Okay.
24.
So my second irregular order is going to have to be the other dude. Let's take that counter off. He's going to have to be real careful here. Now,
models do interrupt line of sight, right?
That's a great question. I have no idea.
But I don't think they provide cover.
Right.
I remember reading somewhere...
You have to do base contact anyways.
Oh, that's true. I remember reading somewhere that they do interrupt line of sight.
Yeah, so I can definitely... We can see each other?
But I don't get any bonuses. So...
Well, it's outside 8. I do it
still
in
16. Less than 16.
So you're a plus 3. I'm a plus 3. I have cover.
Right, so my negative 3 becomes nil, and you have a plus 3 on yours. Because I'm in the open.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're shooting at 8s.
I'm shooting at 11s.
Oh, yeah, minus 3 plus 3. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
So you're shooting at 14.
Right. Sorry.
Right.
You're smarter than me.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's pretty good for me.
Yeah. So you got 2?
Yep.
I got the 1.
So it cancels 13. Out one of
cancel
mine.
Out one.
So you have one armor roll to make.
Let's do it. Plus 4. I get 14. Which beats 13.
That's correct.
Okay.
Yeah. So my turn.
Yep.
I'm going to... let's go. So first order... It's 4, 2 here, and no arrows because they're hiding behind that building there. So I'll do my second 4. I'll just keep beelining it through the open. That's 1. My second one, I think I'm going to move my terracotta soldier over. Nobody can see yet until...
Yeah,
this is the angle.
You're correct.
So I'm going to do my second move. So just put me up there.
Still not sure if there's any line of sight.
Yeah, and it's the second short skill anyways.
Yeah, no, you can't see my guys anyway.
But you can give them another order to... That's what I thought you were going for there.
Oh, to then start shooting?
Yeah.
No, I'm just kind of getting more guys into arrow range for when you move in next. I'm going to use another order... So this is order number 3 to actually move this guy again. So I'm going to put him, 8. This ruler is 8. I'm actually just going to put him right into this corner.
I did it on purpose. You probably made it 8 inches for that reason.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that was my third one. With my fourth one, I am... going to declare a move of 0 on her.
Okay.
And you can arrow with probably both those guys.
Yeah, because if they can both see you last turn, they can both see you this turn. So
mm-hmm.
They're both going to ballista still attack you.
Cool. And then so I'll BS shoot you as well. And I'm going to put 2 shots on the guy in the open and 1 shot on the guy with cover.
Okay.
Cool.
So we do 2 on 1 and then 1 on 1?
That's right.
Okay.
And
again, your negatives count out my positives.
Mm-hmm.
For this guy, you just get plus 3?
Yep. So 14s and you're looking for 11s.
Yep.
Let's do it.
So I fail.
And I definitely... I got both of mine.
And you got both yours. So I got 2 armor rolls. And I got 13 or less. 13 or more.
13 more with plus 1.
So I got 2. But I gotta get higher, not equal to or higher.
Higher, yeah.
Okay, so I need a 13 or higher. So there's a pass and fail.
All right, and then the face to face.
The final one.
So we're both rolling on 11s now?
Yep. I got a critical.
Oh, snap. And I did get 1, but yours is a crit.
Dare you. Yours might be mine cancel yours, right?
And I get no armor, so she gets pasted.
Excellent. But you have more orders.
I do. So that was 4.
We got 1 guy left. Or 1 chick left.
So I'm going to do... I'll do this one order on this guy who's chilling at the corner.
Figured.
He's going to shoot you.
Saw him coming.
Yeah.
So she's going to both steal you back.
Okay.
But she's ballsy like that.
All right. And...
It's on fire.
So I'm covered, but... Yeah, you're not at that angle.
I think we're both just straight rolls at this point.
But
we're less than 8.
Yeah, so you actually, you get to choose what gun you want to use.
That's true, I can use the shotgun.
Yeah, because you're really close.
Right.
gives me plus 6.
Yeah. So you would actually be plus 3 even though I'm covered.
Yeah, so I'd be at 14 or less?
Yeah, and I'm at 14.
Why wouldn't I have cover and...
No, at this angle...
And you have another negative on top of that?
I don't. I don't have rifles, I have copy rifles.
Oh, it's plus 3 at close range.
Yeah.
Okay. So I need to roll less than 14 as well. That's a fail.
Oh, and I got 2.
Okay, so 2 armor rolls. So I'm looking for a 9. Sorry, a 10 to beat 13.
Yeah, right? Go for it.
And 1 fails. That's that's the game.
It's good. Alright, let's set up for a post-game show and see how we feel about adding in a couple more special units.
Alright.
Wow, so game number 3.
Yep. 0 for 3. 3 for 3. Alright, this is not going well.
Yeah. I hope you guys can figure out what they need to, but at this rate, we don't know.
Obviously, we're still getting used to the mechanics at this point. This game really showed me how easily guys die. Like, there's absolutely no forgiveness in this game at all.
Mm-hmm.
Like, in Malifaux, we had damage tracks.
Mm-hmm.
In War Machine, you have damage. Like, a guy can take some damage before he goes down.
Yeah.
In this, they die as easily as my orcs in 40k. And with my orcs, at least I have 120 models on the field. Here I have 5 dudes. The guy walks up a ladder, and, he's shot in the head,
and
he's dead. So,
there definitely is something with the ARO mechanic that we're totally not used to.
No,
because,
absolutely. Yeah.
Because even sometimes, like, in your turn, when I'm killing your stuff, like, I'm not even really expecting that to happen. It's like...
No, I found that with the last game, too.
Yeah.
It's almost like you do more damage to the opponent in their own turn
mm-hmm.
than you do in your turn.
Mm-hmm.
And that seems weird to me, because in my turn, I get to fire 3 dice at you, and you get 1 back. But it seems... It just seems it's working out that you get more damage in when it's not your turn, which is really strange.
Uh-huh.
It's really strange.
Uh-huh. So, and probably part of the mechanic is because in your turn, like, you're moving, and so whether you have cover, like, you don't always have cover when you're moving.
No, exactly.
Right? So then I get to shoot at you if you're not in the cover.
That's what happened to me with my lieutenant.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to get up to the top of the building and move to the front of the building so I can get a good vantage point to the whole center of the board.
Yeah.
As I walk up the ladder, now I'm at the top of the ladder, and there's nothing in front of me.
Yeah.
He's just standing there. So your 3 guys on the other side of the board were like, hey, there's a guy over there. Just unload. he gets shot in the turban and falls over. Right?
Yeah, it's that red turban.
It's the red turban. It's like, look out for the red turban.
Yeah.
It's not even painted red.
Yeah, this map certainly... more challenging. I mean, it's showing, like, I just loaded that rooftop and went to town because I knew I could see so much of the board.
See everything, yeah.
But you had you could have done the same thing on this opposite roof.
I could have to start.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We just had a firefight back and forth all game.
And then just roll dice and see who
gets
better dice.
Yeah, it would be based on the dice rolls. Yeah. I put my sniper up there, which she did pretty good when she got that one shot through, and
yeah.
That was a reaction too.
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't even me shooting you. That was a reaction to your dude
mm-hmm.
who was trying to kill her. So it's interesting that there seems to be more damage being caused in reaction orders than there is in normal orders.
Mm-hmm. So I managed to kill her. Like, she's really hard to kill. She's minus 9.
Yeah, she's like invisible.
And the only way, so I just decided that turn I was just going to use those guys and just constantly shoot at her. And hope to get that low.
Well, it only
dice.
Took your one dude, right?
Yeah.
Your
terracotta
or whatever then.
Yeah, it took 2 orders to do it because I managed to get that 2.
Right.
Right. Which happened to be the crit.
And how often
so
is
that
it
just
2 crit?
Yeah.
That's interesting.
So I knew that was going to be way to fire, you know. It's interesting. Yeah. Infinity. So far. All right, and I hope we learn some more.
Yeah.
So let's add some more models.
I'm enjoying it, even though I'm losing.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go.
It's just, it's going to take us a while to get used to this mechanics, because
yeah,
it is very different than any other game,
mm-hmm.
for sure.
Yeah, and definitely a lot of stuff to remember, like all
it's
the
true.
Modifiers and
yeah.
being over, under, equal, all this
a
stuff.
A lot of math, yeah.
Yeah. So
there was a one turn there where you were like, I need a 14.
And you were like, no.
No, you need a... Because you just... Yeah, there's like, you pay +3, -3, -3, +3. Yeah. And then you're like, okay. Yeah, it's just...
Yeah.
It's, yeah, it's a lot of bookkeeping.
Yeah.
For having 5 models on the table.
Yeah. Here's something I learned too, is I need to plan my turn better when I'm launching my tiger suit in there. Because I realized, like, I could have killed the guy who killed my tiger suit, which would have made her dropping in there a lot more advantageous.
Well, that was our mistake too, though. My first turn, you could have ARO'd with him, and we didn't even realize because he was all the way back here.
Yeah.
So again, that's something about perceiving the whole board, getting used to the mechanics, understanding that guy could have seen, even though neither one of us thought he could have.
Yeah.
And yeah, that would have changed things. I mean, you still won anyway.
Yeah, it wasn't a problem. But...
Without a problem. Yeah. Yeah, there was absolutely like no resistance from the Haqqislam at all. I'm just going to climb this ladder. Oh, crap.
Yeah. Hey, I have a feeling like next game's your game, so let's add some models.
Let's hope so.
And we'll get to it. We'll see you guys next week at our next encounter.
Cool. I like a monkey in a